Welcome you all once again and hope you all are doing well. So today in this class, we are going to study future tense and its four types. So let's begin. So as you can see in the slide, we are going to learn future tense and its four forms. So what is this future tense? Future tense is a time that tells us about future time. Okay, so as I told you, tense is nothing but it is time. And how is time indicated? It is indicated by the forms of the verbs that we use. So that's what we are going to learn in this video. We are going to learn the usage as well as the formulation with the help of timeline provided in this video. So as you can see, a future tense is a verb form that marks the event described by the verb as not happened yet. So the action has not happened yet. It has not taken place, but is expected to happen in the future. So it indicates action that has not yet begun. Okay, so as you can see, forms of future tense, okay, simple future, future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous. Now we are going to begin with simple future tense. Simple future tense has two different forms in English, and as I told you, it indicates an action that has not yet begun. Okay, so it is indicated by two forms, will plus verb, that is V1 form of the verb. And you can see the example over here, you will help him later. Okay, since it is an assertive sentence, affirmative sentence, so there is a full stop used at the end of the sentence. Now the next form of simple future tense is am, is, are, plus going to, plus verb form. Example you can see over here, you are going to meet Ria tonight. So basically simple future tense has two forms, will plus V1 form of the verb, and then auxiliaries, present auxiliaries you can say am, is, are, plus going to, plus verb. Now we are going to learn some of the usages of simple future tense. As I told you, will and going to is used in this case. So will is used to express a voluntary action. You can see the example, I'll send you the information when I get it. I will translate the email so Mr. Smith can read it. So it expresses a voluntary action. Next use, will is used to express a promise. It is usually used in promises. You can see the example given over here. I will call you when I arrive. So my dear children, you can just see two parts over here. I will call you, and then when I arrive, and you can just notice that where there's a time clause, okay, simple present tense is used in time clause. Simple present tense is used in time clause. You can just see over here, when I arrive, okay. So this is also called if clause, and this is called the main clause. So with the main clause, we are not going to use that is subordinating conjunction, okay. We are going to use future tense in this case. So simple future plus if clause, okay. So I will call, will plus V1 form of the verb is used over here. Now you can just see the third usage of future tense, simple future tense. As I told you, again we have this form, be going to, okay, be going to form. It is used to express a plan, okay. So it expresses the idea that a person intends to do something in the future, but that plan may be realistic, may not be realistic. Okay, you can just see the examples over here. He is going to spend his holidays in Hawaii. She is not going to spend her holidays in Hawaii. So I've given you both the examples here. So as I told you, it expresses the idea that a person intends to do something in future. It does not matter whether the plan is realistic or not. So here also in this case, okay, we use simple future tense. Now an offer. I will take you to the airport tomorrow. So as you can see, this is the contraction form of will. Okay, I will take you to the airport tomorrow, and you can just see the time expression as well. So these were the usages, few usages that we have learned, okay, for simple future tense. Let's move on to the next slide now. Now, see, I have just mentioned the difference over here. Difference between will and going to, where it is used. So will expresses future actions described at the moment at the speaking. Example, I will have salad now. So this is immediate decision, quick decision. Okay, so for this, at the moment of at the time we speak, it is used then and there. Okay, so will is used along with V1 form of the verb to express future action decided at the moment at the time of speaking. Okay, so this is immediate decision. This is not planned before. Okay, so this is immediate decision taken. So here for these immediate decisions, we will use a simple future tense, will plus V1 form of the verb. Now you can see the example over here. Okay, so here also, now going to expresses future plans decided before the moment of speaking. So these are the prior plans. Okay, you can just see the example. I am going to visit my aunt next Friday. So it is planned beforehand only. Okay, so when the things are planned beforehand, okay, and it is fixed, so for that we use going to form of simple future tense. Okay, then next use you can see over here, it expresses a future fact. Fine, it expresses a future fact. The sun will rise tomorrow. On the other hand, you can see over here, going to expresses that something is about to happen. Get back, the bomb is going to explode, isn't it? So now we have learned the difference between will, where will is used. Okay, it is an immediate decision. Okay, so and here going to expresses the prior plans made. Okay, so it is a fixed decision made beforehand. Understood? Now let's move on to our next slide. Now, future continuous tense. The future continuous tense is a verb tense that indicates that something will occur in the future and continue for an expected length of time. And here the formulation has been given, how it is formed. In case of affirmative sentence, all the subjects plus will plus be. So be is added in case of future continuous tense plus v4. Since it is continuous, you can see over here, so v4 form of verb is used. Next, you can see the example over here. I will be, so subject is I, will and be, and then again singing, sing, singing. So S-I-N-G plus S-I-N-G plus I-N-G. So it forms your V4 form of the verb. So I will be singing in the concert tomorrow. Now let's move on to the negative sentence. As I told you, not is added. So subject plus will plus not plus be plus V4 form of the verb. An example you can see over here. I will not be singing in the concert tomorrow. So what is added? Not is added. And at the end of the sentence, full stop is used. Now, interrogative, question sentence. Okay, so definitely it is going to use will at the beginning of the sentence. So will plus subject plus be plus v4 form of the verb, and then the question mark is there since it is an interrogative sentence. And you can see over here, example is given. Will you is the subject as it is given over here. Then will you be singing in the concert tomorrow, and then there is a question mark. So this was all about the formulation of future continuous tense. And what it tells us, it indicates that something will occur in the future and continue. Since it is a continuous process, so it will continue for an expected length of time. Okay, so here in the form of chart I have given you, and you are going to note down this in your copy, and various time expressions are also given. You can just see over here, it indicates interrupted actions in the future. Like you can see the example, when you come tomorrow, they will be playing tennis. So what kind of time expressions? All the time expressions are given over here. Okay, now next is actions in progress at specific time in the future. So at 12 o'clock tomorrow, specific time is given, we will be having lunch at school. Fine. Next, for series of parallel actions in the future, he will be watching television and she will be cooking dinner. So parallel activities are going on. For that, you know, we can use future tense, series of parallel actions. Fine. So again, you can see at this time next Friday, so all the time expressions are given which you can use in case of future continuous tense. Now it is also used to ask questions politely about the future. Will you be bringing your friend to the party tonight? Okay, so it is used to ask questions politely, interrogate someone politely. Next, refer to actions that are happening now and expected to continue sometime in the future. And you can just see it is combined with still. So this is one of the important thing you can see over here. Unfortunately, sea levels will still be rising in 20. You can just see the use of still along with this tense, isn't it? Will still be rising. So let's go through it once again. It refers to actions that are happening now at present and are expected to continue sometime. We have learned this, isn't it? To specific, to some time, expected time, isn't it? Sometime in the future. So rising in 20 years. Unfortunately, sea levels will still be rising in 20 years. So these were some of the usages that we have learned, okay, in case of future continuous tense. Now, what points you have to keep in mind? And I have discussed this point at the beginning of the chapter itself, okay? That is tenses. You can just see over here, future continuous tense cannot be used in clauses beginning with time expressions, right? Just now I've told you about this, such as when, while, before, after, by the time, as soon as, if, unless, etc. Instead of future continuous tense, what we are going to use with time clauses, we can use present continuous. Okay, see, you can just see over here, I've given you the examples. While I am going to be finishing my homework, she is going to make dinner. So you can just see, this is, you know, your subordinate clause, and this is also called time clause. It begins with while. So we cannot use, okay, future tense with this clause, time clause. Fine, we are not going to use that. Instead of this, what we are going to write, we are going to use present continuous form. We are not going to use future continuous here in time clauses. So while I am finishing my homework, you can just see I am finishing, present continuous tense. Okay, so with time clause here in this case, okay, when you have continuous tense, we are never going to use future continuous tense. We will use present continuous tense if you have such kind of statements given. While I am finishing my homework, she is going to make dinner. So this is the main clause and this is your subordinate clause. Okay, you can also call it a time clause, and it, since it begins with while. Okay, so with this time clause, we are never going to use, and we will never use what? We will never use future continuous tense if the sentence is in continuous form. I hope you have understood my point. Now, let's come to the next tense. Okay, next type of future tense, that is future perfect tense. Okay, you can just see the timeline given over here. What does this tense tell us about. This tense is used to talk about an action that will happen before a certain point of time in future. Okay, so it talks about an action that will happen before certain, that will happen before, you can just see, before certain point of time in future. It can also show that something will happen before a specific time in future. Okay, so it will start. Okay, it had started, it is going on, but before future. Okay, so it shows an action that will happen before a specific time in future. Okay, so it means unspecific time. You can just see, by next November. So what kind of time expressions I use? You can just see, by next, by the time. So it is not the month of November, but it is by next November, by the time we reach to specific time. So specific time has not been provided over here. It tells us that something will happen before that specific time in future. Fine. So by next November, I will have received my promotion. By the time I finish this course, I will have taken 10 tests. Okay. So it is used in this case to show that something will happen before a specific time in future. Next, to express conviction, your strong belief that something happened in the near past. Example, the guest will have arrived at the hotel by now. Okay, so what do you mean by this? What do you mean by this sentence? I'm sure the guests have already arrived at the hotel. So this is the strong conviction. So this tense is used to express the strong conviction that something happened in the near past. The guest, the arrival of the guest has already taken place. Now, it also expresses or it talks about an action that will be completed before another event takes place, as we have just learned over here also. Okay, that something will happen before a specific time in future. She will have learned Chinese, okay, before another event takes place. What is another event? Before she moves to China. Okay, so it talks about an action that will be completed before another event takes place. Okay, in future, she will have learned Chinese before she moves to China. Understood? I hope it is clear to you all. Next, so these are the time expressions that I use with future perfect tense, and you have seen few examples also in the previous slide. So by the time, before, until, till, by, then, by the end of, by tomorrow. Now, dear children, we are going to learn formulation of future perfect tense in this slide. As you can see, the first of all, we have affirmative sentence. It is formed by adding subject plus will plus have plus past participle. Example has been given over here. I will have finished my report by the end of the month. And you can just see over here, I is the subject, will is the auxiliary verb. Then have is added since it is future perfect. And then have plus finished, that is the V3 form of the verb. Next, we have negative. And as I told you, negative is formed by adding not. So simply you are going to add will not have plus V3 form of the verb. And you can see the example given over here. He will not have done it by this evening. Now, interrogative. Will plus subject plus have plus past participle, and since you know it is an interrogative question sentence, so we are going to use will at the beginning, and then we are going to use question mark at the end. Okay, question mark will be used at the end of the sentence. Fine, you can see the example given over here. So first of all, we are going to use the question mark at the end of the sentence. Okay, now you can see the example. Will you have written me a letter? And then there is a question mark since it is an interrogative sentence. Now let's move on to the next form of future tense, that is future perfect continuous tense. And you can just see over here, it is used to show that something will continue up until a particular event or time in the future. Example, James will have been teaching at the university for more than a year by the time he leaves for Asia. Okay, so what it shows that something will continue up until a particular event Okay, so this is a particular event that would take place. Okay, till then it is continuing, fine, or time in the future. So James will have been teaching process of James, okay, is continued, okay, for more than a year by the time he leaves for Asia. Fine, and this is the timeline which shows the expression, okay, that is the work will continue up until a particular event or time in the future. Fine. Next, it is used to talk about something that finishes just before another time or action, in this case in the future. I will be tired when I get home because I will have been walking for over an hour. Okay, so you can just see over here, it talks about something that finishes just before another time or action. So here is the example given. Since a person is tired, when I get home, because I will be tired when I get home. Okay, why? The reason is given over here. I will have been walking. So this is the action performed by the person. Okay, and then again the cause is also given. Okay, over here you can just see, to talk about something that finishes just before another time or action, in this case it is the future. Now next, various time expressions are given over here. Fine, which is used with future perfect progressive tense. Okay, that is future perfect continuous tense. By, plus, this year, month, week, whatever you want to say. Next year, month, week, for, plus an hour, for 5 years, by then, since morning, since 1995, by tomorrow, so on. Now you can just see the formulation of future perfect continuous tense over here. Since it is continuous, before will be added and been will be added. Please learn, use your tricks to learn the things, fine, and keep it in your mind. So for affirmative, all subjects plus will plus have plus been plus before form is used, and since it is an affirmative sentence, and as I have been telling you, you have to give full stop at the end of the sentence. And you can just see the example. I is your subject, will, have, been eating, before form of the verb, eating vegetables for 3 months. Now negative you are going to add not. I won't, when not is added, will not becomes won't in contraction form. So I won't have been eating vegetables for 3 months, and then there will be full stop. Now we will come to interrogative sentence. Okay, so here it goes. Will plus subject plus have plus been plus before. So will is used at the beginning, since we have to frame interrogative sentence in case of future perfect continuous tense. Okay, so will, then there will be a subject. With all the subjects you can use will. So will you have been eating vegetables for 3 months? I hope it is clear to all of you. So you are going to note down all the formulation and usages in your English notebook. Now here I have given you an exercise which you are going to complete in your copy. Fine. Hope the tense, all the forms of the tenses are clear to you. Okay. And if not, you can clear your doubts. Fine. In the next class. Thank you.